What's up, guys? Quick update on Bitcoin. I know I have a lot of stuff labeled, but I don't feel like removing any of this stuff. But anyways, I do still think this is a completed impulse right here, guys, and we kind of got this dip that we were kind of expecting. If you go look at my previous videos, just for anyone that's new, I was kind of calling for some kind of dip. The last three videos I made, and then I had a lot of green up arrows before that, right? While we were below 60K. So I kind of was calling for some kind of correction, but now we kind of have to see what's going to happen going forward from here. I think there's a balance coming, guys. This area right here is most likely going to get respected. I'm trying to figure out where I had this drawn from, but yeah, if we just drop some fib retracements like this. The 618's kind of stacked there, but this area, that could be like a final area where we go to 58K. But right now, this is just looking like a impulse correction completion right here, like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I am expecting a bounce, right? This area right here is probably gonna hold, but we might tag it 60K real quick. But I do think this is getting a little extended. Now we might be w looking for a wedge. Right, like here, because this is a lot of red candles, we might go up like that real quick and get some kind of red finish before we go up. But I think this, this could probably be over anywhere between like the end of the first week of October. So end of it's Tuesday today, so maybe even over end of this week or end of next week. But I think that this is probably gonna last like 2 weeks, guys. So, I would expect something probably like that. I think it's more realistic, to be honest, something like that. Now, if we do get that bounce, what I would keep an eye on, because this looks like an extended A wave. So let's say this is the bottom, or we go a little lower to this area right here. And we bounce and we say, okay, it goes back up to like 650, 618 area, maybe. I would be expecting either a double bottom right here or like a tag like 58K. And I would think that's your bottom point. But even on the Elliott Wave Oscillator, what we're probably looking for here, I think, is just something like that on the Elliott Wave Oscillator for like a, and just an ABC with divergence and maybe one shallower point, something like that. It's just a corrective period, guys. At this point where we're at, I do have to say that, I have to give an up arrow. But let's go look at high time frames. We're gonna look at some other stuff. But this is still my projection, guys, of the percentages that I have up, that I think it's very likely we're going up from here. Especially after this bounce, it still looks like an inverse head and shoulders at some point, and then we're going up. I do think that's what's coming here, guys. So if we get rid of this. And just look at some indicators, right? This is my main count. The squeeze is tight. I would say it's very unrealistic for this squeeze breakout to happen going down. That would just like that would pretty much be like your 40K tag. Like I said, I don't think that's gonna happen, but if that does happen, it's gonna really suck, because this is gonna turn into like pretty much 2019. Like I said, I think it's unlikely. Right now, I think what we're looking for here that I've been saying is just a simple pack test of this trend line, and then we're gonna go up, right? It's actually very, very technical. That's still what I'm expecting right there. Let's look at higher time frames. Yeah, even the higher time frames. I mean, you have a TD 13 up. That looks like inverse head and shoulders, right? You can see that there. 3 week. Monthly, right? The monthly is pretty nice in that it kind of is backtesting that trend. And if you were to drop low to high 6.8s like that, it's also there too. So, that's all I got for like high time frames. Let's look at a 3 day real quick. The 3 day shows this a little better, guys, that I've been saying that it's pretty much just backtesting that trend line. This still looks like a accumulation pattern, guys. You could see this yourself, right? Like that. It's just accumulating like this. We have a cross up. I think at this point we have to just give up arrows. Now I was calling for a correction, but from here, where we're at right now and all the support we're at and the deleveraging and the crash that already has taken place, I have to lean bullish at this point, guys. So I'm gonna switch back to pointing green arrow, especially for my system, which I'm doing is more medium term predictions weighted towards, where we're probably going on the higher time frames, right? It's kind of what we think. I think we should look at the POCs real quick as well, guys. So like on the 3 day, it's interesting that the POCs actually we front run it a little bit at 67. But I think if we like move it a little bit, I believe there's also a lot of support here, right? But I don't know where I was looking at, but yeah, I guess on the 3 day, the POC is still at 67K. Now, if you go down and look at like the daily, the daily is kind of what I was saying, the medium time frames, this distribution pattern, right? And that's exactly what took place. The squeeze got tight, we broke out of that trend, and we got that drop. Now we're back testing just major support, right? So, at this point, like I said, I have to lean bullish. We're pretty much back testing that trend line as well. And if you drop 618s, we're pretty much at 618. So right now we're at massive support, not only on indicators, but also on the price action, right? Now, what does this look like? Like I said, I've been saying this. I think I've been saying this since this point here, where I thought, we were looking for a 1212, right? So 1 2 3 4 5 ABC, and 1 2 3 4 5. So, from this point, I thought we were looking for probably a 1212. I do think that's what's going to happen here. So realistically, what's going to happen is we should be bouncing. I mean, that's you can see the gaps. You got two straight red candles like that, right? So, I'm expecting something like that, and then like that, and maybe that's your actual bottom point. But if we do break that level, then like I've been saying, I'd pay attention to that little bit lower level right there. So we gotta adjust these real quick. So that's pretty much what it looks like on the daily. The massive support area, I think, is we already tagged one of the massive support areas. I was telling people in my Discord, 62K is pretty much your first big support area, and then your second support area starts at 58K down to this level right here. I would say those are your two areas to pay attention to. So what that means is that we're literally at the first major support area, and then the second major support area, in my opinion, based on everything that I'm looking at, is this fat area, right? Like right here, right? A lot of times, if a lot of liquidations occurs, a lot of times we get a correction down to like that tip point right there, right? A massive wick to that point, it would still put up a higher low, so I would watch out for that, right? You should probably keep up that trend line like that open, right? And something like that, see kind of like a wick area, right? So that this area right here would be like your wick area, guys. In my opinion, that's an area to get over leveraged without any chance of liquidation. What does that mean? You could take out loans if you're not going to get liquidated. I think that's okay if you could pinpoint exact bottom points. It's what Michael Saylor does, but he doesn't like pinpoint exact bottom points, right? But he has no risk of getting liquidated, and he's over leveraged, and that's fine. If he's very like high probability that if he thinks it's 100% going up, it's absolutely the correct move, right? So, I was discussing this in my Discord as well, but yeah, so that's what I think right now. I think those are the two support areas, right? We are at mass support right now, so I'm gonna have to give a positive up arrow on this video, but it does look like we're in probably at least a 2 week downtrend of some sorts, guys, right? So if this right here is an impulse, like I said on the lower time frames, then I do think that we're probably looking for just like a ABC like that with a shallower C wave, because this looks like an extended A. That would be my guess right now based on every prediction in advance, right? So even if you look at this, it doesn't look bad. We're just back testing that trend line. We had a TD11 on the tip right there, right? We're definitely waiting for some kind of more accumulation going on, right? So we could get something like that, and that would be a little better looking, something like that, guys. But I think we're gonna bounce here, guys, so I wouldn't worry here. Let me see where the 1 day POC is at, actually. Let's see, the 1 day POC support area is right at 58K, guys. And then the 8 hour POC is a little higher, so we might back test that area right there at 63 to 64K. And then we got to kind of relook at things. But that's kind of what I'm leaning right now, guys. So here's my low time frame count. I am expecting a bounce of some sorts, maybe to this area right here at 64, 65K before we get a final drop, and then we go to the moon. That's kind of what I think right now, guys. So, you know, let's change gears real quick. I look at the Russell. The Russell is back testing major support on the trend lines. This is exactly what happened in the last two cycles before it went parabolic, right? Back tested, back tested, back tested. And when it finally broke the all-time high, that's when Dogecoin ran up, right? I think that's literally around the corner. And even on the indicator, it looks like it has some room up to go. Let's go look at some different angles real quick today, guys. So if you look at the liquidity heat map, guys, I mean, we just had a lot of liquidations that just took place. We just picked up a lot of liquidity here down to 60K area. So this would like very likely being a first bounce area, guys, where we were probably going to get a bounce here. I just want to point this out real quick. The other thing I want to point out, the hash ribbons, actually, I don't know if anyone else stopped looking at the hash ribbons, but we had a second capitulation here, actually, guys. This looks very similar to after COVID, not before COVID, because it, you know, during COVID we had one hash regions capitulation right here, then we actually went back and had a second capitulation. This looks very similar to that, right? So it's very likely, I think, that we're like here somewhere then, if you want to compare it to a past cycle, right? But either way, when you get something after the fact, and this is bottom, that's, you know, historically a pretty good spot to get in, right? At the bottom point, like we have right here on these spots right here. But, you know, we're just even looking for just this buy indicator is pretty good as well. So that's kind of what we're looking for, is a second buy indicator. I'll keep you guys updated on this. Also, I pointed this out on my Discord yesterday, that on my crosses script, we did get some red crosses here, right? This happened actually kind of, you know, got our first one right here. And then, you know, I guess this happened during the red candle. Either way, I did post this on my Discord. You know, I'm only doing probably a video every 2-3 days until I start getting more subscribers, maybe every 3 days. But when we're bullish, I'll still probably do altcoin videos at night. But, you know, I'm just not getting money subscribers, so it's just easier for me to post on Discord real quick on this, but at least I'll be doing some videos every like 3 days. And when we're back in a bullish trend, I think even right now, I think, you know, when we're bullish, try to do more altcoin videos like at night, at least key altcoins that I'm, you know, or meme coins or whatever. But, you know, we did get some crosses down. And you could see the script has just been really good, guys, like accumulation, distribution, accumulation, this right there, accumulation, right, over and over again, massive accumulation here, and now we're getting some red crosses, right? So what's going on here? You know, I've been saying I think this is still an accumulation area. That's kind of what I have to stand by here. You know, obviously people are going to say, oh, that looks like an ABC. You know, I think this is just a tricky 1-2-1. Like that, guys. And I think the way this is falling is actually pretty good. I think this is going to be over quick, like a quick deleveraging, guys. Let's just go look at some key metrics real quick, guys. If you look at my model, this is another reason why, you know, I thought we were going to distribute. We got overheated, right? And then the RSI had divergence up right here, and it's kind of going back down. I think, you know, obviously, you know, what's kind of weird is that this support area in the middle has just been getting ripped through over and over. It literally, this, the RSI literally just goes to 80, then it goes back to 20. I mean, is this time going to be different and we actually respect this 40 area on the daily? You know, we know that it is a support area, but, you know, based on the previous patterns, it's just 20, 80 over and over again. And that's literally your bottom top point. Could have been literally that easy for like the last, you know, 3-4 months, guys. But now we're just keeping an eye on this area as support, but we're probably going to break to 20. I guess we would have to assume. Now, MACD is at the top of the range. It crossed down, and we did have divergence. So, you know, a lot of indicators are showing that we're in a probably at least a 2-week correction, guys, starting from probably this week, or I guess, or like the end of last week. It's kind of what it looks like. Now, the volume is still at a low point. We want this to stay low as the price drops. That's always the best. And we want this thing to start going up with the price going up. The volatility, we are going down on volatility and volume, which is a good thing for now. You know, the net funding and open interest was at a high point. This is another tell that we were very, very over leveraged, guys. So I show this all the time, and at least the open interest is going down, but the net funding is still at a high point. So this is going to take a while. I think best case scenario, we just consolidate for Bitcoin price. So, I'm not expecting any crazy bounces. We are at massive support though. That's that I would pay attention to go the ratio multipliers. That's what institutions are using based on what I'm seeing of where they put their buys and sells, guys. So this is probably one of, if you want to look at only one thing, I would pay attention to the golden ratio multiplier. But sometimes it also stacks with historical Fib retracements like this area right here, which is at 58K. That's what I'm saying, 58K. And especially if you look at the way this is forming, that looks like order blocks on the closes right there. So this 58K level looks unbreakable to me, especially as other, especially when sentiment's opposite, right? But right now, I have to assume that we're probably going to respect that area at least short term. But if we do go lower, guys, I think 58K is unbreakable. I mean, I guess that's like more like 57K, 55. Yeah, it's about 58K, guys. Keep an eye on that. This was we had a lot of sell pressure last few high time frame closes. That's why we're gonna want to zoom out, look at high time frames, guys. But this is why I think this is still gonna take a while. It might take a couple weeks, might take like a month. It might take the first half of October, but we definitely look